Hi everybody, today I would like to speak about the luteal phase. The luteal phase is the phase that is after the ovulation. When we speak about 28 days, it's from day 14 till day 28. We know that the progesterone is the major hormone that is responsible and which is abundant. So, what does progesterone do? Progesterone is rising after the ovulation, and when the level gets high, the temperature of the body rises. The pregnancy needs progesterone for loosening and relaxing the muscles of the uterus. So progesterone is important also in order to facilitate the movement of the blood in the muscles of the uterus. So the blood vessels in the endometrium is rising and the glands secrete more glycogen. So when we think about it from a TCM point of view, we understand that progesterone first has a chi function, the kidney and the spleen chi function, by controlling and relaxing the contractions of the uterus. This is the first thing that we need to remember. The second thing that we need to remember is that progesterone rises the temperature. So it has a bit of a yang and a warming concept. But is progesterone is only qi and yang? We need to understand that progesterone also has other functions, such as it reduces inflammation. It also helps to thicken the endometrial layer. So by this function, we may think that progesterone also influences the blood, first by the blood movement and secondly by the blood nourishing. So in this luteal phase, when we say that we need to think of the pathologies or we need to think of the functions of the progesterone, we need to understand that progesterone is not only qi and yang. It also has functions of moving blood, of nourishing blood. It helps the muscles to get more relaxed. This is why, for example, in this period, women get more constipated. The muscles not only in the uterus gets loose, but also in the intestine. When we treat the lady, we need to consider and ask ourselves, is her yang energy is sufficient? What about the qi movement? What about her blood movement in the body? So usually what we need to do is to use our hands and to palpate, to touch the body. We can touch the meridians, we can touch the yin meridians of the leg, and especially the area of the thigh, the inner thigh, the inner yin meridians of the thigh. And sometimes we see here congestions, we see pain in those meridians. Another area of the body that we need to consider is the abdomen, and especially the area of the dimai and the lower part where the inguinal. In some cases, in the luteal phase, we see a congested area. It means that the woman in this case is lacking a good movement of qi and blood in the lower jaw. So sometimes we feel here the area of the dimai, it's tough, it's painful, it's uncomfortable. The dimai is responsible for the movement and the good flow of the qi and blood in the lower jiao. If it's not smooth enough, it means that the qi and blood are not flowing freely, are not tonguing. And what we need to do is to open the meridians.